You may have noticed we're testing a new Golf, but it's not of the latest Mark 7 variety. This Mark 6 Golf R Cabriolet is kind of like a last hurrah for the old model, a near £40,000 last hurrah. In simple terms, it's just a cabriolet version of the Golf R hatchback, but there are a few key differences. First, there's the 2-litre turbocharged engine underneath the bonnet, which produces 5 brake horsepower less, so that's 261 brake horsepower. Then there's the fact that this is front-wheel drive only, and that's because the extra chassis strengthening for the convertible means they can't fit in the extra drive shafts. So it's heavier, it's front-wheel drive only, and it has less power. Doesn't exactly sound like the perfect recipe for a performance car. And it all shows in the figures. The 0-62 time, for example, is 6.4 seconds, which is almost a second slower than the hatch. It's not even that much quicker than a Golf GTI. But forgetting all of that, how does it actually feel from behind the wheel? Well, we've got pretty perfect conditions here today because it's dry and it's warm. And even here, you can still feel the wheel scrabbling around, trying to get the power down when you're accelerating. And I reckon that's going to be a bit more of a problem when you're back in the UK and it's colder and wetter a lot more of the time. It is fine when the power can get to the road because it does feel pretty quick. It doesn't feel quite as frantic as the hatchback, but it still feels fast. And it's great at going around corners. There's a tiny bit of flex in the chassis and you can feel it coming through the steering column. But there's not too much body roll, so it kind of gets away with it. But in the end, there's not really any getting away from the fact that this car is a lot more expensive than the hatch and it only feels about 90% as sharp.
What you notice more than anything, though, is that the Golf R Cabriolet is far from being a hooligan. If you set the optional adaptive dampers to comfort, you can happily poodle around without really noticing how stiffly sprung it is. You can put the roof up in about 9 seconds and then you get a pretty sorted cruiser. There's barely any wind noise at all.
Volkswagen knows they're not going to sell that many of these in the UK, and there's a very good reason for that, and it comes down to the price. Either you pay £8,000 less and you get a Golf GTI Cabriolet, which feels almost as fun and almost as quick, or you pay £7,000 less and you get a Golf R hatchback, which feels a hell of a lot quicker and a lot more sorted in the bends. There is one more choice though. If you spend the same amount of money, maybe a bit more with a few options, and you sacrifice the rear seats, you could get yourself a brand new Porsche Boxster. And that's definitely something worth considering.